So here you can see one thing, we have not logged into Figma account or anything like that. And this is how the view looks like when you open the link which was shared by your friend or any. So now let's try to zoom in and try to observe. And also here you can see my name is being visible over here because I am currently editing that particular sheet. And this way you can easily collaborate with your other designers and developers as well. You both can collaborate and design a view. You may be anywhere throughout the globe, but you can design a file with the help of the Figma tool at once. And it will also clearly show like you are working on this particular third screen by labeling your name over here. And see how our design looks like now. So this is the way we can get started with the Figma design. In this vlog, we will try to see how to make use of a tool called Figma in designing your application. So if you are a designer and not sure regarding the code, like how to code your components, then Figma is the best tool which you can get started with, and it will be very helpful for even beginners because you will be provided with a lot of components from the Figma community, and you can make use of these components and try to get started with your first design. So I have logged into my Figma account, and it's very easy to sign up for a Figma account. You can just log in with your existing Google account and it will not take you more than a minute. And now here, this is the dashboard which you can see now, and there are various options available for you, so don't get confused and get started with your design file. And as you can see, I have already made few designs on my Figma account, and I will show you from the scratch like how to get started with this particular tool and create your first design. Let's tap on this particular button like explore community, and here also you do have an option like design your file. And when you tap on this, you can just get started with your own design, with your own ideas. But as this is the first tutorial using Figma, I will help you with predefined components available in the Figma community. So here you got this particular screen, and here you have a search tab. And here I'm going to search like component UI kit. And this one is for iOS applications I am searching. So you can just specify the same. And here you can see we have got some suggestions like iOS 15 UI kit for Figma, and also 16 is also available for us, but I'm going to select 15 for now. And you can just tap here like open in Figma. These are all the various components available for you. So now let's try with them in our design. And this is how our first design is now created. So we have created a new design file now. And this is based on iOS 15 UI kit for Figma. And these are all the available options here. And when you first time come to this particular page, you might feel a little bit confused like why these designs are so small. And you might not be able to have a complete view of them as well. So you can just zoom in and zoom out based on your requirement. And you can find like what are all the components available here. And you can make use of them. And if you are not habituated with this particular view, then no worries here. You can just get started with a frame, and I will show you like how you can know all the available components much easily. So here, these are all the frames available for us now. And by default, phone is been selected. And you can also design for various other platforms like desktop, watch, paper, social media. And in social media you can just also design post to Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. You can customize those posts with the help of the Figma tool over here. So now let's get started with the phone here, and I'm going to choose iPhone 14 Pro here. So don't get confused, we have selected iOS 15 and trying to make use of a 14 Pro now. So that doesn't matter, like again, these are just components you are using in this particular frame, that's all. And this is a hand tool here by using which you can move your board. And when you don't want to use the hand tool, just tap on escape button in your keyboard. and I'm just zooming in a bit more. And now let's try to make use of the local components available in our UI kit here. And what are all the local components here? You can easily see like action sheet is available for us, alerts, app clips, and all these things are available for us. So now let's get started. And in this part of the tutorial, I will just show you how to make use of these components in your design. And making use of this tutorial, you try to add your own customizations and try to design it, and share me the file in the comment section below. So such that most of the designers who wanted to get started in this particular design field might get benefited with your designs. So various designs get together. I will also share those design files in my website so that they can reach you out if they are in need of those designs. So now let's get started with the lock screen here. And you can just add this lock screen here, and there is nothing you need to do here. This is a first screen for every application. So imagine you are trying to design a screens for an application and you are trying to provide for a developer. So this is the best way to start with the lock screen here. You can just provide a lock screen here, and I'm going to add one more frame. And again, this is of iPhone 14 Pro. Again, when you want to move this to the right of this frame, you can just tap it over here and try to observe how I am trying to move this frame here. And in the second frame, now I'm going to consider few things like an input box here and also a few buttons we can add to our design. So let's think like a login screen here, and also you can find the constraints here. You can just match it over them, and if you want to have a bigger button, you can just drag and make the required button size. And also we do have few aspects like editing here. If you are not sure like what you can find, you can just specify here text, and the related components will be populated onto your screen here. So I'm going to add a text field over here and need some padding, so I'm going to adjust this accordingly. And now you can easily copy and paste these components such that you can add multiple components now. And when you want to drag both these components, you can select them and you can just drag them and place wherever you require it. So I just require it over here. And also we are missing a status bar here, so let's try to add a status bar as well. So I'm going to pick this particular status bar and going to add it over here, and this will get adjusted accordingly. And this is just considered to be my first page, like login page here. Okay, and similarly I want a dashboard page now. So what I'll do is like easily I just copy this screen and paste it over here, and you can see we have got like third screen now. And here I don't require these two things and a button. I am going to remove those things. And what we need to add over here, so let's try to see through the components available for us. And if you are dealing with a payment related application, you can just make use of an Apple Pay icon over here. So it's like Apple Card, and you can just tap on it and make some purchases after the user login. So just adjust it accordingly. And also we do require a footer over here. We do have a status bar, and let us try to see what are the options available in the action sheet. Also you can just add few options. And here under the tab bar here, you have got few options, and I'm going to add this as our tab bar. And this is a label again. Here you can see switches and sliders here, so you can make use of them. And we can add a switch in our login page, and there you can just also specify if we have any text widget. Okay, so I'm going to make this. And you can edit the title accordingly and say like you are accepting the user terms and conditions before getting started to using this particular application. And also you have some text selection fields over here. So these are just design purpose things I'm showing you. So these are not related to any part of the coding. And when you provide these particular designs to the developer, then they can get started with the coding by having an idea like how the application will look like. And also we do have an options like face ID here. And also let's try to have one more screen there. I can show you like how you can add a keyboard. So in the keyboard here, keyboard section, you can just drag and drop a keyboard, and you can also add a view for it. And here we do have some messaging bubbles over here, so you can drag and drop them and show in the similar way. You can just expand the image size. And also in the navigation bar, you can just add a search button over here. And we do require the status bar, so let's add it over here as well. This tutorial will be helpful for you in getting to know how to start with your first design, because it might be quite confusion for you when you start with directly. So here in the login page, I'm going to add an icon such that it looks much better. And also here you can have some wallpaper on your login page here. Now in your login page, you can just drag and drop a wallpaper here, and also you can just place it like this onto the frame. And here you have an option like send to back, and when you tap on send to back here, you can see our wallpaper is being adjusted properly now. Okay, so now let's zoom out again. This is a basic design now, and let's try to see few more things. Like when you tap on the get started button, you need to move to the iPhone 3 version over here. And before that, let's try to preview this in a screen here. So this is just like your emulator or simulator in your Android device or iOS device. So whenever you're trying to present this, this is the best way now. You can just say it's like a first screen, and again this is a second screen, and here you can clearly see like we have got some adjustments to be done. And I will quickly proceed with those things and show you again. And this is how the design works actually. So this is the second screen, and now when you tap on get started here, we want to move to the third screen here. Okay, so let's see how this can be done. So just tap on get started button here, and in the prototype you have like interactions, and in the interactions you need to select navigate to, and here we do have our designs. Like we are currently in the second screen, so it is not showing the second screen, it is showing the third, fourth and first screen. So let's tap on third screen here, and also you have an options to specify the animations as well. So you can just specify smart animate, dissolve. So let's try to see what's dissolved, and now let's try to preview. Now when you tap on get started here, you can see this is how a dissolve look when you move from one screen to another. Okay, and you can also have some back animations as well. So just add a button over here in the third screen and try to add an interaction, and then come back to the login screen. So let us consider that interaction to be a logout screen, and here you can see it is clearly showing you in the design. And one more good feature which we can find in the Figma is like you can share this particular design with your friends or the developer easily. You can just copy the link, and now I'm moving through a private window, and this way I will open this particular design over here. So here you can see one thing, we have not logged into Figma account or anything like that. And this is how the view looks like when you open the link which was shared by your friend or any. So now let's try to zoom in and try to observe. And also here you can see my name is being visible over here because I am currently editing that particular sheet. And this way you can easily collaborate with your other designers and developers as well. You both can collaborate and design a view. You may be anywhere throughout the globe, but you can design a file with the help of the Figma tool at once. And it will also clearly show like you are working on this particular third screen by labeling your name over here. And see how our design looks like now. So this is the way we can get started with the Figma design. And if you are having any queries in this usage, just let me know, because as a beginner you might have been struggling to get started with Figma and few options are quite confusing if you are using it for the first time. So I will be ready to help you with the particular usage. And also there is a tool like converting the Figma design to the code and making use of them in your Flutter application or HTML React Native based applications as well. But I personally don't suggest, because those components doesn't suit well in your application, because the code is being quite complex when you try to convert a design to a code. And sometimes you might not even understand few things, like why a small component is being overcomplicated with the help of these tools. But anyhow, if you want to have a look like how a design is being converted into code, just ping me in the comment section below. And also don't forget to share your links in the comment section below, and we will be discussing over those. And also don't forget to share your links here in the comment section below. I will be also discussing them in our next tutorial if I get few links from you, and if you really wanted me to share those with other beginners as well. And also I will share them in my official website. So this is it for this particular tutorial, and if you are having any queries in this particular tutorial, do just let me know in the comment section below. And in the coming tutorials, we'll be seeing more interesting topics on Flutter. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.